What is spanning tree protocol? Before we answer that, we need to discuss and understand what a layer 2 protocol is and how they work. As this is only a quick tutorial, we won't be going into too much detail. A layer 2 protocol, in its most simplest terms, is a bridge that connects two or more networks to a source, such as two computers connected to a local area network via Ethernet. When the network is as small as this, not much can really go wrong. Problems only begin to arise when more and more switches are connecting to the network. One of these problems is duplicate unicast frames, and this can happen when one device attempts to send information to another device via a switch. The switch receives information but doesn't have any record of the recipient device in its MAC address table, so it floods the unicast frame out on all switch ports. Eventually there will be connecting switches that finds the device intended to receive the information, but depending on how many switches there are, that information will be received numerous times. In this example, PC1 is attempting to send a file to PC4 through switch 1. But as switch 1 isn't connected to PC4, it sends information to PC 2 and 3, as well as switches 2 and 3. Switch 3 finds a device called PC4 and passes the information on. Switch 2 doesn't find the device, so forwards it on to switch 3, then sends information again. So in this situation, the file is sent to the right device a total of 2 times, as well as sending it to each other device connecting to the network. Another issue that can happen is a broadcast storm. This happens when a network is overwhelmed by continuous traffic. The reason for this is usually due to low port rate switches and improper network configuration. These issues can be resolved by ensuring a network keeps a well-organized and loop-free hierarchy, and that's where spanning tree protocol comes in. Spanning tree protocol is a layer 2 network protocol that makes sure that there is only one logical path between all destinations on a network by intentionally blocking redundant paths to cause a loop. A port is considered blocked when user data is prevented from entering or leaving that port. If the path is ever needed to compensate for a network cable or switch failure, STP can recalculate the paths and unblocks the necessary ports to allow the redundant paths once again become active. Let's go back to our earlier example regarding duplicate unicast frames. Introducing STP to this situation enables the information sent from the initial device to be received without any unnecessary diversions or duplication. This works by assigning priority between the switches and the ports to determine the most efficient route for the information to be sent. The way STP finds these routes is by first identifying the route bridge between the switches. This is usually calculated by which has the lowest MAC address or the most bridge priority. Let's use an example where the route bridge is the one with the lowest MAC address. The next step is to determine the route ports for all bridges except the route bridge. These ports will be the ones directly connected to the route bridge. Any switches not directly connected to the route bridge has the route port determined by the connecting switch with the lowest cost. In this case, it would be the one with the lowest MAC address. The third step is to pair all of the route ports with designated ports. After this is done, the paths with undetermined ports need to be assigned either designated or blocked. To do so, priority is given to ports with the lowest cost to the route bridge, and then the lowest bridge ID, and finally the lowest port ID. Once the blocked ports have been decided, they are paired with designated ports. With this, the spanning tree protocol is now complete.